What's up, Whitney? I'm your host, Susan.
And I'm your other host, Miguel, and welcome to our live special. Happy Halloween.
It's not Halloween, that's next week. But this week has been Red Ribbon Week.
To learn more about Red Ribbon Week, here's a video from ASB.
Hello, my name is Dr. Joanna McManus. I am a credentialed school nurse for ABC Unified School District, and I am currently the school nurse at Whitney High School, Haskell Middle School, and Cerritos Elementary.
Hi, Whitney Wildcats. I'm coming at you live from Seoul. I'm really happy to be with you guys for Red Ribbon Week. My name is Alicia Hannah Kim, and I'm on Cobra Kai. You may know me as a very scary sensei, Kim Dan.
Hi, Whitney. Hi, Wildcats. Happy Red Ribbon Week. My name is Olivia Liang. I am an actor. You can see me on shows like Kung Fu on Max or Legacies on Netflix.
I love playing card games and board games. I actually carry a deck of Uno and playing cards in my purse. I know that you can play these games in your mobile phone nowadays, but I enjoy the feeling of holding those playing cards and playing live with someone.
I never did drugs when I was in high school. I was too busy eating and talking in class with my friends and not studying. But I also felt really cool not doing drugs because I was feeling everything that I wanted to feel, and I was also sharper and felt healthier. So that is probably something that I could say from personal experience that I would share.
As an actor, there really is nothing else like it when I get to step onto set and become a different character and tell a story from their perspective. It makes me feel alive and excited and inspired and passionate. And I feel the same way when I read a book or watch a movie or a TV show. Any kind of storytelling really gets my gears turning and makes me feel excited about doing things and about doing more.
Unfortunately, most adolescents are now approached younger and younger to try illicit drugs. I can't reach those who approach those adolescents directly, but I can tell my students and educate them that temptation and peer pressure will always be there. You just have to have that willpower to overcome those temptations and not just give into peer pressure. Just think about your future. Even if you just try it, you might not understand what you can actually do to your body, short or long term. So why even risk your future? What is the science behind drugs do to a person's body? I'll try not to get too technical about the pathophysiology of what a drug can actually do to your body, but I will tell you that it may change the inner workings of your body's organs. There is a chemical in your body called dopamine. Dopamine is released into your brain to give that sensation of feeling good. Naturally, your body uses dopamine to regulate your mood and assist with your body's physical function. most drugs desensitize that dopamine receptor. And that's why your body continues to crave that substance, because you still want that feeling of sensation of feeling good. So some of those effects can actually be temporary, but some of it can be addictive and can be permanently damaging, especially if it is used long-term. So eventually your brain will deteriorate and lose your areas of where critical thinking and judgment are essential. Areas of decision-making, learning, and memory, and behavior control can become really affected. Do you really want to do that to your brain and your body? You only have one life. Why not live it without damaging it in the process?
There's someone pressuring you to do drugs, and you don't want to, try to put that boundary down, try to create some distance, maybe talk to another friend, get some help with that. In terms of people that attempted to do drugs, I would say that it is a short-term solution. It's a short-term solution to how you're feeling, and you have to do it over and over again. You have to keep chasing it, and that makes you a prisoner of that short-term solution. So it's not sustainable.
My hope for you guys is that as you go through high school, and if you want to go to college, or you're going through young adult life, you find something that you're passionate about, that you can channel your energy into, that really makes you feel alive. And don't worry if you haven't found it yet. Don't worry if it takes a while. It is a lot of trial and error. But when you do find that thing that you're passionate about, it really is a natural high. It really will make you excited about life and sharing it with others. And so I hope that you guys all find that thing and you're able to channel your excitement into it. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you so much for having me, you guys, for Red Ribbon Week.
Thank you so much, ASB.
Hey, are you excited for Halloween?
Yes, I'm so excited.
You know what I love to do during Halloween, though?
What?
Watch a bunch of scary movies, of course.
Ooh, not me. But speaking of spooky films, Mr. David's class has prepared some amazing spooky short films. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
First up is a short film called After School.
Hey, what'd you get on the stats test?
Oh, you don't talk about that. It was kind of hard. It was really hard for me.
my gosh, that one was so spooky. The next short film is called Keep It Down.
All right, check this out. Look, you can't beat me, bro. You can't beat me!
Oh, that's what I'm talking about. You're so bad at this.
Oh, my God.
Let's go, dude.
I can't play with this tiny controller, man.
Oh, dude, just gotta make excuses again. Come on. Shut up, man.
You know I'm better than you. Come to my base later. I was having an actual rematch, actual controllers. You know I'm gonna beat you.
All right, bet. I'm down.
Let's go.
What's up, guys?
Hey, man.
Oh, what's up, man? Oh, shoot. You trying to come with us later? We're gonna have a rematch, because this guy thinks he's better than me.
Bro, I am better than you. What do you mean?
Didn't your neighbors say they didn't like people coming over?
I mean, they don't like them when we're too loud, but, you know, just don't be too loud and we'll be fine.
Dude, I thought they said they would, like, cut out your tongue if you were too loud.
I was, like, 5 years old at the time, you know? They're just trying to scare me.
They're gonna do that to a 5-year-old? That's crazy.
No, don't worry about it. Just don't be too loud. And
oh! No way! Oh my God!
Not quite.
Oh no! Oh!
Oh shoot, man, it's getting late. We should go home, honestly.
One more game. How much could one game hurt?
All right.
What? Did you guys hear that?
What? What is it?
Did you guys see that?
No.
See what?
Like a shadow.
Oh, what are you talking about? Shadow?
Really gotta check this out.
Dude, what if it's just the neighbors?
You really that scared of a cranky old dude? Come on, let's go. You guys see anything?
Nah, dude, I can't see anything.
Yo, go find a flashlight. We're gonna go look outside real quick.
Okay. Guys, I have the flashlight. Oh my God. Are you okay?
Our next short film is called Sleep Tight.
Yo, what's good, Kaius? How you doing, man?
What's up, Kevin?
Yo, what is that? Bro, what do you mean? You're tripping, bro. How you got glasses and still can't see?
What? Bro, I swear there was something there.
Bro, you good, man?
I don't know. I think I'm just tired.
Yeah, for sure. All right, let's go. Come on. Are you good?
I don't know, man.
Forget it, bro. We gotta go to practice. Come on.
God, dude, school was terrible, bro.
I know, man. You know that Calc BC exam? Dude, I got a 99%.
Dude, shut your... Bro, did you see what happened? No. Dude, did you see the level 5? Yeah, bro, did you see it?
Bro, what is wrong with you, bro?
Bro.
Oh my gosh.
Dude, oh my gosh, my eyes were blessed. Like, I'm not even lying, my eyes were blessed, dude.
Man, you need some help, man.
Dude, class was so worthwhile today, dude. Hey, besides that test, though, low-key.
Man, screw homework. I think I'm gonna just crash.
Bro, me too. I'm so tired. Hand me that, man. Thanks, bro.
Yo, did you hear that?
Bro, why are you so annoying? You act like a 5-year-old. Why does you look like one?
Oh.
Dude, is your dad playing tricks again?
No, dude, my parents are out of town.
Oh, heck no. You go check. It's your house, bro. You got it.
No, dude, wait for me.
Go. Dude, are you okay? What is that?
Yo, bro, are you good?
Bro, dude, I'm fighting demons in here.
What? Oh, shoot.
Lucy! And I will always love you.
Three times? Three whole times? You kidding me? That's insane.
Yeah, dude. I heard he was begging. Hands clapped together, tears in his eyes and everything.
Bro, that's insane. What the heck?
Yeah. Anyways, you still at school right now? It's like pitch dark outside.
Yeah, school's pretty close to home, so I'll be back in a bit.
Like, alone? Isn't there like a serial killer in that area? Like, dude, my mom's been crazy over it. She decked me out with a bunch of pepper sprays and stuff. Hey, you want one?
Nah, that's gotta be a rumor, bro. We live in the safest neighborhood of all time. There's no way.
Yeah, true. Anyways, I gotta go now. If you die, though, I want that Leve album.
Yeah, whatever. I'll write down my will. Call you later, I'm almost home.
next film called The Ghost Project.
Please tell us what exactly you know about the Whitney ghost.
Oh man, so what happened with me was I came in late. I was here working on some stuff, and I literally heard singing in the auditorium. I walked over. I don't know if it was. I walked over, checked it out. Nobody was there. It was the creepiest thing.
Well, the Mac building over there that was built like 12 years ago. I've been here since forever. And anyways, since the Mac building has been built, we've heard lots of things like screaming, scratching, someone clawing, trying. I mean, it sounded like someone was trying to claw the walls. Yeah.
Gretchen Whitney was always fond of the performing arts. I think she's upset because it was named after Miss Who. I think she's haunting this place.
Tonight, my friend Christian and I will find the mysterious Whitney ghost. My other friend Aldrich, / cameraman, will be recording everything. But what was that? Christian? Christian? What? Christian? Was that you?
Christian?
Where
is he?
Wait, I see something.
Where? My God. What is that?
It's keys.
It's keys?
But why would they be
here?
What do you think happened?
I'm not sure. You think we should check around back?
Maybe.
What was that?
Hey guys.
What was that? Christian?
Christian? Christian, where are you? Christian? What? He's not here.
This is taking too long. Well, are we even sure he's alive?
Well, of course he is.
I don't know, man. I think we should just leave, man.
What? You just want to leave Christian?
Yeah. I think so.
You know what? Fine. Whatever. Just give me the camera.
Fine.
Here, take this. Yeah, I'm out of here.
Bye. Whatever. What? What was that? What? Aldrich? Okay, this is getting too spooky now. The light! What, my phone died? You've gotta be kidding me. Okay, maybe the camera has a light. Huh, this camera has night vision? Wish I knew that earlier. Oh, hey, there's a door. You know what, I'm just getting out of here. Ah!
Thanks for all those short films, guys.
Wow, those really spooked me. Maybe those ghosts have something to do with the random scary videos that have been interrupting us this month.
Speaking of ghosts, Dia de los Muertos is starting.
You can find our school's altar at the corner of Bojorquez and Barry's room, and you can add pictures of your loved ones until next Friday.
We hope you enjoyed all the spooky videos, and thank you for tuning in into another episode of Whitney Live. We'll see you next week.
Have a happy and safe Halloween.
Go, go.